Yes. So I'm very excited to see the emergence of the platform, which can produce more than thousands transactions per second. It's very important for our Nasdaq on blockchain. We need to trade hundred thousands of tokens backed by equities and debt and real estate and artworks. Could you elaborate a bit? How is the system will be able to process such an amount of data and transactions?
Yes. So on that same point, you're exactly right. There's a huge gap at the moment between where we think the space is and where it actually is. Right now, the biggest ICOs in the world are really Bitcoin and Ethereum. We're giving them $5.5 to $6 billion US dollars a year, and they're using it to process 20 to 25 transactions per second, coming in at around $7 US per transaction. So in order for this industry to grow, we need something much more scalable. EOS is an evolution of technology that has existed for some time, a project called Graphene, and we're able to do about 100,000 transactions per second on one chain. In addition to this, we're able to actually simply add another chain as soon as the throughput of the entire network reaches its capacity, right? And we do this through asynchronous communication and moving away from a state machine into a messaging machine. So instead of actually hashing the state every time something changes, and if you think about how that would actually work, if you had a video game, it would mean that you needed to redo the proof of work hash every time your pixel changed on your monitor, right? We restore something that's extremely intuitive, which is a message machine. So these messages can be replayed and the state can be deterministically applied. So the bottom line is that EOS is using the strongest throughput on a single chain that exists today. In addition, it's making it parallel. So we can scale into the millions of transactions per second with nominal costs.
Brandon, this will be a revolution for capital markets. I worked for 7 years at hedge funds, and I see how big are costs of transactions for capital markets, and money flows are not as efficient as it could be. To make a transaction, it takes T+2 days for settlement. Cost of listing are very high, and also there is a huge load. If you can process this, this will help to emergence of stock exchanges on blockchain, which processes all of these deals. By the way, what do you think, what is the best asset class to start with? What kind of assets need to be tokenized in the first place?
Well, I think all assets can benefit from tokenizing things, but the biggest effect is going to be asset classes that don't currently or suffer from illiquidity. So I'm a big believer that property is going to be huge going forward. But yes, you're going to need high transaction volumes, and we keep saying that we'll solve those problems later as we reach scaling limits. But the reality is that it's time to stop, you know, waiting for these problems to be solved. The answers are here, the future is now, and we need platforms that can handle these types of things if we really want to start leading this disruption. Bottom line, I think property is the biggest disruption.
By the way, would you like to make a token sale of your house? We can do it in a few weeks.
Yes, I think that this is the future, absolutely. Yeah.
And you will keep it for your own use, get cash, do not pay rent, do not pay interest.
Yes, you need to do it in a market at which it allows you to trade digital securities off of registered exchange, and there's only a few of them today. We're actively talking to some of them on things that you can do with this. But I think that countries that are willing to allow digital securities to trade on third-party exchanges are going to be the leaders in the revolution of digital securities.